Blockchain Bernie here, broadcasting live from sunny California. We have been running our Solana validator for almost 2 months now. And why did we do it? Has it been profitable? Has it otherwise met our expectations? That's what we're going to talk about today. So why did we choose to run a Solana validator? And for those of you who know me, I have started Bitoku Labs. So it is a storage layer for the Solana blockchain so that developers that build dApps for Solana can use a storage layer. So we're working tightly with Solana. We've participated in their hackathon and all these things. So we thought, like, we're kind of part of the Solana family now. Why not run a validator? The Solana blockchain right now has about 2,000 validators in all over the world. And the hardware requirements for a Solana validator are a little bit higher than for other blockchains. That's because Solana aims to be the fastest blockchain in the world, which they are. And I think it's important because we need to scale, right? Crypto will only make a difference to the world if it scales to basically anyone, and anyone can use it. So we love Solana for that reason. And also, obviously, we're building our own blockchain, the Bitoku storage blockchain that will communicate with Solana using Oracle technology. So we thought, like, hey, we can collect valuable experience by running a Solana validator and you know, learn from that when designing the Bitoku blockchain. So how has it been going? With Solana, you need to have, you know, quite powerful hardware. I would say, you know, if you buy the hardware new, it's about $5,000 as a minimum. Better you go higher, right? It's, you know, if you want to have top-notch hardware, it's going to be like 10K. And then you need to put in a data center because, you know, you can run a Solana validator at home, but, you know, with those ISPs that give you internet at home, you need quite some bandwidth. I would say it's got to be 1 gigabits per second, right? The minimum requirements is 300 megabits. But yeah, you should have 1 gigabit. And many people have that at home now, nowadays. But if you have like a residential plan with that, you know, you don't have that bandwidth all the time, right? In the evenings when everyone's watching Netflix or so, bandwidth just goes down, right? It's just shared with, you know, other people in your neighborhood. So most of the time it's no good and you have more failures there than in a data center. Data centers have redundant internet, right? So if one provider fails, it automatically fails over to the other one. So, and you know, you need to validate Solana transactions because you get credits, you get paid for validating transactions and for your uptime. So, you know, every time your bandwidth is down, your server is down, you know, it'll bite into your earnings, and it is tough to get profitable running a Solana validator. It takes time, right? So for us, when we started the first 4 weeks or so, there was, you know, almost nothing coming in because you need people to stake Sol. So Sol is the native currency of Solana. You need people to stake Sol with your validator, right? So people who have Sol, they like to stake their Sol because it earns them what's called an APY, annual percentage yield. So it earns them some sort of interest. And the term interest is a little bit misleading because the interest is paid in Sol, and Sol is an inflationary currency at this point in time. So that means all the rewards that the validators get are newly issued SOLs, right? So the total number of SOL that is outstanding is constantly increasing. So if you stake your SOL, you're basically protected against inflation, right? It's not like a real interest that you're earning. But, you know, you never know. Hopefully SOL price goes up again. And then, you know, you make a profit just from the Sol price increase. And in addition to that, you earn that APY, right? And then the higher the APY of a validator, the more people like to stake with you if you run a validator. So you have to be a high performance validator. So we got, you know, great hardware and put it in a data center, have that 1 gigabit connection. And guess what? We're, you know, even after that short time, we're among the best performing Solana validators, which is great to know, right? So by APY, so we have those over 2,000 validators now, and we have constantly been, you know, in the 70s, 80s by rank with all validators sorted by APY. So you can go to a site called stakewiz.com, and that's stake, and then wiz.com, link in the description. And there you see all the validators, and you find the Bitoku validator there as well. And, you know, I've prepared you the link to our validator, the Bitoku validator, on Stakewiz, just right down in the description. So check it out. So, so we've been, you know, 2,000 validators. We are at position 70, 80 or so by APY. I find that quite great. And if you look at the top 50, most of them charge zero commission, right? So here's the thing. The validator owns APY for all the people that stake Sol to our validator. And then we can keep some percentage of that for ourselves for running the validator as a commission. So when some people run it at zero commission, but they have to pay the hardware, the data center, and they have to pay quite high cost in voting, right? Because those validators, they all vote for every block that's being produced. There's going to be a voting going on. And those vote transactions are just regular transactions on the Solana blockchain with Solana. That's quite different from other blockchains. So, and these transactions incur a transaction fee, which is super, super low with Solana. But if you, you know, vote the whole month, and you know there's a block every 400 milliseconds, you have to vote a lot, and those fees add up, right, to about, you know, I would say 0.8 sol per day or something, you know, times 30. That's gonna be, you know, quite a substantial amount of sol and money per month, and you need to get that back by validating transactions. And you can only get it back if, you know, if you can attract a lot of stake, right? So people need to stake Sol with your validator so that you can earn APY for them and keep some of it as a commission. So that's how you can get profitable. So we staked about 3,000 Sol of our own money into our own validator. It's a little bit over 3,000, I believe, right now. And we've got about 50,000 Sol after 4 weeks, I believe, or 6 weeks, maybe. We got about 50,000 Sol in stake, thankfully, from a stake pool called Marinade. So Marinade is the most, you know, most accepted and most used stake pool on the Solana platform. So people stake their money not only to individual validators, but they can stake it to Marinade. And Marinade is liquid staking, so you get a token back from Marinade, which you can use for DeFi purposes, right? So it's like normally when you stake, your Sol is locked. But if you do the liquid staking with the stake pool, well, your stake is liquid, right? You get something back from Marinade. And then Marinade stakes to a set of validators. And thankfully, they picked us to give some of their stake to us. So that's great. So now the big question, is it profitable? Well, not yet. So with the hardware that we have right now and the data center and everything that we're paying, we would need like 120,000 Sol in stake at our 5% commission that we've set to be profitable. But I've seen so many validators that grew their stake over time, especially if they're active in the Solana community, talk a lot to people on the Solana Discord, or, you know, provide some tools that are useful for everyone. Over time, you can accumulate quite some stake. So I'm quite hopeful that we will become profitable with that Solana validator. But the main reason why we did it is to gather experience in running a validator. What's really going through the mind of people that run validators, because we're building that Bitoku blockchain and you can become a validator as well. So by the way, our launch for the public is on November 5th. So don't miss that. Go to bitoku.io, link in the description, and you can purchase a node license to run a validator in the Bitoku blockchain. So we're gathering important information on Solana, on how everything works. And do we like it so far? Yeah, the community is great. So there's a special Discord channel for validators, and they're all very helpful. Those Discord channels in the Solana Discord, they are being policed by probably, volunteer people that, keep out people that spam and stuff like that, which is very important. Sometimes they're a little bit on the tough side with their policing. So it, for my taste, it could be a little bit less, but it's needed, right? If you want to keep the community clean, you need to make sure that, you're not being spammed and people ask questions in the right channels and stuff like that. So Solana is doing a great job there. And overall, they are super helpful, helping every new validator getting up and running and everything. So yeah, our goals have definitely been reached. So I can recommend it. It's a little bit of a larger thing. And in the Bitoku blockchain, we aim to have lower hardware requirements so that anyone can run those validators at home and things like that. Solana has their reasons to have these relatively high hardware requirements. And I think those reasons are perfectly valid for Solana. And, it has been a great experience for us. Also for our node store, now we have, when we sell the node licenses for our Bitoku chain, now we have our own Solana validator, because all our store, the e-commerce store where you can purchase those Bitoku licenses, it all runs on the Solana chain. And now we have our own validator that gives us access to the Solana chain. And we're not dependent on other like RPC nodes or something to do just that. Yeah, so that was my little experience report with running our validator. I'll definitely give you an update on that. I just mentioned a few things on the sidelines, like how to stake on Solana, how the inflationary thing works and stuff like that. So if you're interested in tokenomics, what are tokenomics, and a deep dive into Solana tokenomics, but also, of course, our Bitoku tokenomics, just let me know down in the comments if you want a video about that. And otherwise, thanks for listening, and talk to you soon.